Friday lunch, Friday lunch. Made it through the week and you didn't get punched. World's gone crazy, but I got a hunch. We'll all feel better after Friday lunch.
Well, guys, welcome back to Friday Lunch, the show that brings you the best of East Nashville's live music scene. With me is one of my favorite artists in the community and really anywhere, none other than Kevin Gordon. Kevin, how are you doing, man?
Good, Korby.
Long time no see.
Yes.
I feel like the last time we hung out was on stage at 30A.
That's correct.
Yeah. Trading songs for the good people there.
Yes.
So I think that was in the before times.
The before times it was, yes. Yes. 2018, maybe. I can't remember. No, maybe 19.
Yeah, man. Well, I'm glad that we are finally getting to reconnect under like such favorable circumstances.
That's right. Yes.
Getting to hear you play your songs. Let's get into it a little bit after this, but I'd rather just jump right into a song.
Okay.
You want to set this one up?
Yeah, I thought I would, you know, just do like a few from different eras.
Yeah, man.
And this was the title track of the second record that I made for my former label, Shawnakee. It was called Down to the Well.
Cotton shotgun shakes, a red door on a green Cadillac, hot wind blowing smoke through graveyard streets, face I recognize looking right through me. Ain't going down to the well no more. Believe I had my fill. I worked that ground till I done got sore. Ain't going back down to the well. Played that dive 20 some odd years with the faith and the whiskey you killed your fear. I remember the night you broke down to the core. That black Stratocaster through a plate glass door. Ain't going down to the well no more. Believe I had my fill. I worked that ground till I done got sore. Ain't going back down to the well. Work that got sold. Ain't going back down to the well. Ain't going down to the well no more. Believe I had my fill. Work that ground till I done got sold. Ain't going back down to the well.
Fantastic, man. I could tell where the lyrical dedication is coming from, and you're really honing in on the right words in the right order.
Oh, yeah.
As a compliment. And also as a segue to some of your backstory, which is, we were talking in the kitchen a few minutes ago, and you moved here from Iowa City, and that was because you were in the MFA program at U of I?
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah.
If you don't know the U of I Writers Program, what is the name of it?
University of Iowa Writers Workshop.
Basically the most prestigious, most difficult to get into writing school that you can try. I know because I fancy myself a writer and didn't have the cojones to try myself. I did go for Vanderbilt's program, but
cool.
They just saw right through me.
Oh.
does that mean that you were like a bit of a book nerd or?
Oh yeah. You know, it's, I don't read as much as I used to. In fact, that's one of the first things, you know, they told us going into, you know, the first year there was read as much as you can because you'll never have as much time for the rest of your life.
While you're in the program. Read right. As much. Yeah.
Yeah. Because, you know, it was a studio degree, which meant you take a seminar that meets once a week. You take a workshop that meets once a week. Otherwise, you know,
yeah,
time is your own.
A lot of unstructured time. And that's probably like part of the schooling is that you got to figure out how to organize yourself. Otherwise, you're, in my case, playing Nintendo all day long.
I'm still learning that, trying to get that right myself.
Since we're going on a tour of Kevin Gordon's catalog, maybe you can play one from another chapter.
Sure. This is from the next to newest record, if you don't count the brand new one that's in the can.
We never do.
Comes out later.
Until it comes out.
And having grown up in Louisiana, I tend to use that landscape a lot for the stories I tell, and those stories a lot of the time come from there.
Sure.
So this is a true story, not that we get extra points for that, but...
Oh, we do. I'm going to cut in front of you before you get started.
All right. All right.
Daddy got a job at T.L. James, bought himself a GTO. Daddy got a job at T.L. James, bought himself a GTO. Had a little baby boy and a pretty wife. It was pedal to the metal to the getting good life. Horn rim glasses, pocket protector on his shirt. Horn rim glasses, pocket protector on his shirt. Looked like some uptight, upright church going nerd, but he loved to hear the carburetor rumble and purr. Quick and quiet as a switchblade knife, pedal to the metal to the getting good life. Full moon over Woodlawn, full moon over Cedar Grove. Full moon over Woodlawn, full moon over Cedar Grove. Early next morning, Mama put the coffee on. Looked out the window and the GTO was gone. Glass in the driveway, skid marks out on the road. Glass ice in the track, we skidding marks out on the road. Talking to the cops, say they didn't hear a sound. Hot wire spot, joyride bound. Quick and quiet as a switchblade knife. Pedal to the metal to the getting good life. Later, the ugly truth was revealed. 3 days later, the ugly truth was revealed. Sergeant called my daddy, said to file a claim. We pulled your GTO out across Lake with a chain. Two black boys done it, we got them in the cattle jail. He said it was two black boys done it and we got them in the jail. I never knew why it mattered that they were black. The GTO was gone, it wasn't ever coming back. Quick and quiet as a switchblade knife. Pedal to the metal to the getting good. Got a job at T.L. James, bought himself a GTO. Daddy got a job at T.L. James, bought himself a GTO. Had a little baby boy and a pretty wife. It was pedal to the metal to the getting good life. Quick and quiet as a switchblade knife. Pedal to the metal to the getting good life.
Save all my words for when I'm in the microphone zone.
Okay.
Man, I think I saw you. Did you post that recently on maybe the gram from the Five Spot, a live performance?
Yeah, maybe so.
I feel like I caught that and it kind of lit a fire a little bit.
Oh, cool.
Good to hear it live.
Yeah.
We've heard two story songs.
Yeah.
Is that what you feel like you're an expert or, you know, if anything?
Well, there's just some stories that just, you know, seem suited for
lend themselves well to
what to do. And, you know, the last one, I tend to write songs at least in the last 10 years or so about the racial tension that, you know, has always been present in the South and a lot of other places, and the ways in which those ideas you know, bounce off of each other, and you know, that whole thing came out of thinking about when I was a kid and I was told that story about my dad's car getting stolen, that, you know, it was always made clear what the race of the perpetrator was, you know, and looking at it from a very dry perspective, you know, you ask, well, why does that matter? In a way, yes, it does matter, but my point being, it's just weird.
Yeah, sure.
At a certain level, you know.
Sure.
So, you know, it's not always a comfortable look back, you know, but
it's your past, you know, you've got to deal with it one way or another, or yeah, not. And I think, you know, part of their job of songwriters is to help, you know, people deal with shit that they maybe don't want to,
yeah,
in a way that's accessible. The songwriting process, I'm always interested, everybody who comes in here, I'm just like, everybody's got a different approach to like doing this. And for you, is it like, do you come at it from an idea first, or is it like you play around with some hook in your head for 5 weeks before you get around to doing it, or is it different every time?
The easiest ones are like GTO, which happened like in 10 minutes. Once I had that opening line, it's like, oh, I know that
you weigh into
pretty
that.
Well.
Yeah.
So let's just play this and see what comes out. And, but you know, it often I'm just fooling around musically. I often write on this guitar or another guitar in this tuning, which is open D. So that can lead to some happy accidents that sure. I wouldn't find otherwise.
You know? How'd you find your way into open D for composition purposes?
Well, I was actually terrified of playing solo in standard tuning. I felt like, I don't know, it just felt really rigid to me. I wanted something that sounded really wide.
Yeah.
And I just kind of stumbled into it and started making the chords often without playing the third of the chord mm-hmm. so that it sounds a mile wide, you know? So, I mean, since then I've kind of gotten to know it a little better and I'm more intentional about whether it's major or minor, but, you know, it's a weird little thing to get into. And I found this guitar at about the same time. This would have been, you know, 93 or so. Mm. A songwriter friend of mine had it propped up in the corner of his apartment. And you could see the cobwebs, you know?
Yeah.
I was like, you don't
it's
need
an invitation.
That. I need that.
Yeah.
And I loved it, you know, from the moment I picked it up. And yeah, so it was a happy collision of things.
Sure. That's just amazing how like a physical object can really resonate with a you know, a creative heart. It just seems, I don't know, like one guitar is just like any other guitar. I know that's not true, but just that you could pick up something and be like, oh, so inspired by it.
Yes.
That is part of the lore of, I think, guitar lovers. You know, every guitar is a little different, not just because of the way they sound, just because of the way they are.
Yeah.
A little bit of the magic.
There's that thing, you know, people say that, you know, guitars have songs in them, you know, or instruments have songs in them. And it's your job to get them out of there, you know. You know, and this one certainly has brought out a lot, you know, for me.
Well, let's bring out one more, maybe. Do you have time still, Kyle?
Yeah, I got time.
Okay.
Okay. Here's one that's going to be on the new record.
Kevin's going to play us on out. You guys, thank you so much for hanging out. Next week we have Melody Walker, who's coming into the studio to share her thing. Kevin, it's been such a pleasure. Thank you so much for spending a little time with me.
Thanks,
and
Corby.
Let's get together and write one.
Yeah, man.
Okay.
That sounds great. Thanks for having me.
Marion, different from the other boys, didn't give a damn about no football game. Old Lilyville gonna always be the same. You went far from where you came, Marion. I was 15, you waited tables at the restaurant where I washed dishes with a black man full of rage. I was too white to see his cage, had to keep himself tucked in just to survive. Maybe you felt the same, holding your true self down inside. You were 25. Reagan won, and the virus was a mystery, but not the apathy, nor the hate from the nation or the state. You watched your friends just weaken and wither down. And the killer still could not be found. Reagan won. Late night disco, little bar in the shadows. There is no sign on the door. You could finally feel free for a while. Far from the Baptist eyes of scorn. Marianne, 20 years on, I got the news. Single gunshot self inflicted. Last thing you saw consisted of semis blowing by, shaking gray weeds out past the shoulder where the vultures feed. But it's your kind of soul this cruel world needs, Marianne. Marianne.
Friday lunch, made it through the weekend, you didn't get punched. But I got a hunch, we'll all feel better after